Hello, everyone. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening to everyone around the world. Welcome to In the Moment. I'm your host, Paul James Sisler II. And today, Jay is not with us as a host. Today, we have L.R. Evans. Hello, Luke. How you doing?
Meow.
Meow.
I locked
Is this
Jay.
Exciting or what?
Oh yeah, no. Jay's locked in a basement, sans kneecaps, so that's why I'm here instead.
Yes, yes, we're sawing Jay's kneecaps off. So how you doing?
I am doing well. I'm making some headway on the outlines for the sequel in my Rimworld trilogy, so that's fun. And otherwise, just kind of jamming out to some awesome music.
Yes, yes. I was jamming out some awesome music also. Definitely, definitely. Well, well, well. Should we just kind of get right into it then?
Yeah, I let's share our playlist with them.
All right, everybody. The premiere episode of the premiere band, Vainglory.
Hey, we're Vainglory, and this one's called Inside and Out.
Now, baby, I love you.
Excellent, excellent, excellent. So, the lead singer of this band, Vainglory, is none other than J.H. Colts. Hello, Jay. Can you introduce us to the rest of the band? Can you hear us, Jay? Can you hear us?
Can you hear us? We can't hear you, and now you can't hear us? Can you? I can't hear you.
I can't hear you.
Vainglory destroyed their own mic playing that song. No. <We'll be
back. laughs> Yes, yes, they will be back. Heard the song, but then everything else went. All right.
Can you hear me?
Yes, can you hear me?
When did it cut out?
Right after the song was over.
Perfect. Yes. All right. So that's all I give a fuck about.
We got the whole song, and I said, after the song was over, I said, now I introduce the leader of the band, the lead singer, J.H. Colts. And Jay, can you introduce the rest of the band? And I got no response.
That's exactly what I did preemptively. I didn't hear you. You didn't hear me. But preemptively, in 1 second. On guitar, Caesar. Yay. And on drums, Lucas.
Yes. So, what brought the three of you, the three-man goth band, together?
Truthfully, it's kind of on a whim. I was kind of like spastic, sporadic. Luke mentioned something, and I was like, you know what? Fuck it, I'll do a band. And then, bam!
I love it. I love it. You know, Jay, you're an awesome writer. You're an awesome orator when you read. And now I got to add to the repertoire. You're also an awesome singer.
Thank you. Thank you. But all glory goes to Caesar. Glory to Caesar. Funny, right? The reference to...
Well, they're all great.
It is. It's all
great musicians. Great musicians. I love the sound, everything. Kind of had a little Glenn Danzig sound going there. I was like, wow, I'm liking this.
I mean, I'll take it. Yeah, we were influenced somewhat by Depeche Mode, a few other notable 80s.
The Cure. Misfits.
Absolutely. Yes. I said Glenn Danzig. I said, yeah. Yeah, so like, that's perfect.
Yeah.
Yeah. Excellent. So, you got more for us?
Two more.
We do have two more. Do we do it now? Sure.
Yeah.
Do it now, I'll
fuck
it.
Yeah.
Second song. Let's go with the next one, and then when you come back, we'll have Luke ask some questions.
Devil in Me, this is about toxic masculinity.
Right, right. Let's see. All right, so this next song is called Devil in Me, and it's about toxic masculinity.
Just one more time before
Before you sleep inside your home, I'm in your wildest dreams. That's when you kick and scream. I hate you, don't you see? But you love me like a living thing.
Before I have Luke jump in here and all that and ask some questions, Caesar, where are you from, brother? And what inspired you to play music?
Can you hear us?
Yes.
No. Yes?
Yes.
Fantastic. One second. Caesar, that question's for you. We'll take a break before the third song.
Right. What inspired me to make music? Okay. Let's see here.
Welcome to the show.
Okay. All right. So I don't know. I guess I really loved the atmosphere of concerts. I've been going to concerts since I was 6 years old. My first ever concert was 6 years old. I was at this venue. I think it was called the Dog Pound out in San Francisco, and I saw this hardcore band called Project 86. It was pretty cool. And from that point on, like, my life changed forever.
Wow. How old were you when you picked up the guitar?
I was 9 years old when I took up the guitar.
Nice, nice.
I'm 25 now, for context.
All right. Lucas, same for you. What inspired you to be a musician?
Basically just listening to all my favorite bands, all my favorite bands that I have. I've practically been listening to them since I was in the womb. And just listening to all my favorite drummers inspired me, to do music.
Awesome. Awesome. And how old were you when you first started beating on the drums?
4 years old, and I'm 22 right now.
Excellent. Excellent. Luke, what you got for us?
Well, I'm going to go with the basic question of where do you come up with your song ideas? I mean, obviously, the one about toxic masculinity is easy. That's the one where you just kind of like push back against the toxic masculinity. but like, where do you get your beat? Things like that. Not so much the lyrics, but like where do you draw inspiration from with the music itself?
Okay, well, for that one, Devil in Me, it was an easy target because it's easy to make fun of a stereotype, especially whenever that stereotype is something you see everywhere. Usually ideas just come to me, usually, like I can be walking along and then I'll have like a melody and then I'll be like, ooh, I gotta hum that into my phone or something, you know? They seem to just come out of thin air sometimes, but I think that's because I spend a lot of time thinking.
All right.
First performance as a band, but have you guys performed before in front of people? I mean, I know Jay hasn't, but how about you and Lucas?
Caesar and I have performed many times in front of people before with our other band called Forgotten Faces. It's more of a death metal band. But yeah.
Excellent.
Yeah, we got Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, TikTok, all of it is at Forgotten Faces Official. All lowercase, right?
Except for the Twitter. That one's a little weird.
Oh, the Twitter's different?
No, just for ours, but...
Yeah.
Okay.
You want to give us a follow, though, at Vainglory Goth on everything.
Definitely. Okay. Ed says, your sound is reminiscent of Depeche Mode and Orgy. Were those predecessors and influences?
Yes, absolutely. Ed, cheers to you, because nail on the head.
Hail and horns.
All right. Luke, did you have another question? Because if not, I've got a huge question here. Okay. Jay, it is rumored that you have kissed all of your band members.
One more time.
It is rumored you have kissed all of your band members.
Hold on. How the fuck did you guys get that information?
Jay, when you're drunk, you talk.
Oh, yeah. Double confirmed.
So, is it true?
Yeah, double confirmed. Triple confirmed at this point.
Yes, triple confirmed. All the rumors are, in fact, true.
Okay, so my next question is, Jay, how do I sign up to become part of the band?
Oh, yeah, that's easy. Go to...
Zane wants to kiss you.
just submit a request at Vainglory Goth on Twitter, and you know all your dreams will come true. Except for that, that costs more.
Because you know, baby, I love you inside and out, right? Like,
yeah, no.
All right. So, do you have any future gigs already planned, or are you working on that, or what's the deal with this band?
You got this one.
Okay, so I actually am connected with a promotion team here in the valley where we live, where we're located, and we do gigs in a lot of the surrounding towns, me and Lucas, so we've actually never played as Vainglory in front of a live audience, but I am more than confident we can get in. Just got to get some similar bands, maybe play at a few of the dark 80s and goth nights that they like to host around these places. I think that would be pretty awesome. What did you guys say?
Agreed.
Yeah. I think that would be a great start. I mean, everybody's there. It's already a shared demographic.
Sure.
Might as well.
All right. We have another question from Cornelia Blackmore. I want one, but I can't sing for shit, so I'll just be the eye candy. Is that cool?
The kiss thing? No, just you can play the tambourine or whatever. That's fine. You know, we're not picky. We got
the electric triangle.
How gruesome. Love it.
Oh, is that a song? Is that a song?
No, it's a torture instrument.
Oh, well, there you go. Now you can make a song out of that. I already got the word. Shit, I'll write it down now. Damn. Oh, man. I'm loving this.
Yeah, honestly. Just having fun.
Okay. Cornelia responded, oh, bet I can do that. So Cornelia is going to be applying for the position of tambourine player.
Excellent. Awesome. Give us a follow, Cornelia. We'd love to hear from you. At Vainglory Goth on Twitter, at Vainglory Goth on Instagram. And if you're one of those old farts that uses Facebook like me, Vainglory on Facebook.
We've got all the bases covered. Except for bases. We have bases.
Yeah.
Fuck.
Currently holding auditions for a bassist, so
yeah. Bassist.
All right, and that at on Twitter is at Vainglory.
Vainglory Goth. It's crucial to include the goth part because otherwise I'll end up at this weird video game thing and we're not associated with them. It's a disclaimer.
Okay.
Yeah, just coincidence.
Okay, so Jay, I just put it up on there. Is that correct?
Let me check.
Vainglory Goth.
Yeah. All lowercase.
All lowercase, and you'll know it's us whenever you see the Rose profile picture and the cover photo is the words Vainglory with an underline, and there's like a rose in the lettering.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm sorry. Anayat wants to know what your next move is as a band. So what are you doing after this show?
After the show? I mean, Anayat, if you're hosting an after party, we would happily show up to it.
You charismatic motherfucker.
I think she means in general, like, what's your next gig that you're planning on doing?
Oh, right. Okay, so in general, all jokes aside, since we already have the stuff here, we're actually planning on recording all three of the songs. Yes, there's a secret third song that we haven't done just yet, but all three of the songs, and put them up on Spotify and
SoundCloud, YouTube, all that good shit.
SoundCloud, YouTube, and all that good shit. So in case you did like our music and you want a higher quality, just a higher, they'll be available there. So, you know, when you're either fucking someone or planning on fucking someone over, the songs are there.
All right. Ed had another statement. He says the drummer has a Gene Krupa and Bix Beiderbecke style. Do you have experience with jazz style of skin drumming?
Lucas, do you want to do some jazz right now on your kit?
Sure.
Exclusive. Here you go. It's a little bit of jazz.
Okay, hold on. Before he does, hold on. In response to Bix Beiderbecke, just so you know, I'm from Davenport, Iowa, and we used to hold the Bix Beiderbecke Jazz Festival every year. So love Bix Beiderbecke and love jazz. So let's hear it. Let's hear it, Lucas.
That's Lucas. Oh, such a traditional group. Let's go.
Yeah.
Personally, I mean, honestly, huh?
Well, sorry, I forgot to unmute my mic. We have another question from Togo Pro. I hope I said that right. Togo Pro 3. How did you come up with such a unique band name?
They're asking about the name, Caesar.
Seven Deadly Sins.
Microphone.
The Seven Deadly Sins.
Yeah, we're quite a big fan of you know, Vain Glory. Plus, look up the definition. It's quite the definition. We're writers first and foremost. Like these guys, they're writers. We're honestly
writers, authors, that kind of stuff. Like me and Lucas, we have a concept album to our name. For our band Forgotten Faces, called The Bloodline Curse. That's the name of that album. It's about Edgar Allan Poe's short story, The Fall of the House of Usher. A little plug, if you want to check it out, it's on Spotify.
Nice.
I like the history of literature.
Dana Brown Dolan asks, what's your favorite song to play?
My favorite song to play?
All of you. Yeah. What's your favorite songs to play?
Okay. All right. Interesting. Well, believe it or not, I like to screw around with classical guitar a little bit, so I'm quite partial to Minuet in G by Johann Pachelbel.
Ooh, fancy!
Yeah. I really am a fan of classical music. I studied music in college. I have an AA in music.
Oh, nice.
A prodigy is what you are.
Shut up.
Okay. I'm giving you credit where credit is due. Honestly, the fucker's a prodigy. Your favorite song to perform?
In order?
No, in general, man. In general.
I don't know if I have a favorite song to perform. I guess anything that slams.
Hey, I'll agree to that.
But I am a fan of a lot of, you know, metal music, heavy music. So anything that's of that, in that category, I like to play it because it just stimulates something primal in me.
Lucas Smash.
Love it. Personally, outside, of course, these songs, which I love to perform each one of them, they got a substance to them. They're unlike the last one. But outside of that, I'm a big fan of Radiohead, so singing Creep is a treat.
Oh my God, you're going to have to do that. You're going to have to do that. I love Creep. That's like one of my favorite songs. Okay, hold on. We got another question.
Yeah. Guess what? They're saying yes. We'll do it.
Oh, beautiful. One more question before we go to Creep. Which musician would you like to feature on your album and why? Asked by Anayat LJ.
Ooh. Oh, start with Caesar.
Okay. Well,
all right. Okay, so if I wanted to feature anybody on our Vainglory record, it would be Robert Smith because duh.
Agreed. That's a good one. What do you want to be featured on Vainglory?
I'm probably Danzig.
Danzig? Yeah, that's a good one. That's a good one. All right. If I'm being honest, I wouldn't mind getting Attic out of fucking retirement and then having him perform.
Yes. Yes. I can agree with that. All right. Casey's
in there.
All right. I'm going to mute the mic and have at it, guys.
Oh, shit. I need to pull up the lyrics.
Yeah, because for some reason, my mind is fucking blanking.
Hey, we could duet this.
Dude!
Yeah, we could duet this.
A duet?
Yeah.
Don't mind if I fucking do.
I'll have to come scoot next to you, though.
All right.
We'll rearrange your sexy ass.
Then, shit, I'll follow your lead, man.
All right,
I'll just count it in.
Run, 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 run. The people that are listening, this is not a professional studio, so when you kind of stepped away from the when Caesar kind of stepped away from you, the sound kind of changed a little bit, and then when you hit those high notes, I don't think the phone could handle that quite so well. It kind of garbled a little bit, but it still sounded great.
I apologize. I really do.
Too hard.
We did. We rocked way too hard, and our setup is not adequate, I'll be honest.
Yes. No, and I'm wanting people to understand that, because if this was in a studio, trust me, the sound would be a hell of a lot better. The sound would be a hell of a lot better.
You can hear studio recordings. You can hear studio recordings
tomorrow.
As soon as we release them, yeah.
They'll be available tomorrow, actual studio recordings.
Nice, nice. You'll have to put the link out and all that, and we'll have to retweet the fuck out of that.
Yeah.
Hell yeah.
Yes, yes, yes. All right, Luke, more questions. More questions, Luke.
No, I got something. Are you thinking about maybe trying to make this into a career?
Creativity has always been my career, and it will always continue to be my career. So I feel pretty creative.
Hey, I feel pretty great about spending the rest of my life with you.
Hey, I mean, shit, propose.
Oh, are we getting a marriage proposal there? Was that a marriage proposal?
Cut that.
Oh, rumor has it.
I'm marrying my BAM.
Oh, love it.
Polyamorous marriage, but I think it might be illegal. We're trying to fight for it because there would be obvious incest going on.
I love how Lucas is like, fuck you guys. You guys do your shit. I'm not in this.
Lucas is like, can I at least marry outside the band?
You can marry outside of the band, Lucas, but you have to bring them into the band afterwards. That's how it works.
Don't worry. When I'm president, I'm going to make sure that anybody can marry anybody and however many people they want to marry. This monogamy bullshit comes to an end.
Fuck monogamy. In fact, corporate La La Land.
Yeah.
Okay, but I just like how you were like, Lucas can marry outside of the band if he wants to, but like then that person has to come into the band. It's kind of giving me Amish.
That was the exact reference, and I'm glad
you talked. Why do we always come back to this?
No. it's nothing personal. It's just our thing, you know?
You gotta be part of the family. There's secrets here. Secrets here that only marriage can ensure won't leak out.
Okay, somebody asked how long have you guys been playing music together as a band? And our host, Luke, answered, they've only been playing together for a couple months, actually, and they already sound so good.
Couple of months. That is a lie. That is over-exaggeration.
Last week.
Last week is when we've actually, like, legitimately started to perform. Like, we had the idea of having a band, and that festered for a couple of months, and then finally we were like, hey, you want to do a live performance? Sure, we don't have any fucking songs. Okay, let's do this.
I'm not
the most reliable source, okay? But listen, I said 2 months and they were like, wow, and now you just said a week and it made it sound even better. So honestly, I think that I'm doing pretty good advertising wise. I'm just saying.
Thank you, Luke.
So of the songs, we already know that you didn't write Radiohead's Creep, but the other two songs that you've already played, did you write those?
Original.
Okay. I'm going to be up front, and I want everyone to remember this. I didn't write shit for Dick. That's Caesar. That's all Caesar. Caesar is the mastermind behind all
okay.
this. I just came with to him with an idea, a concept,
okay.
and he made it real. Now, of songs, Inside and Out, that one maybe like, what, a month? That's like been a brainchild for about a month with a few other...
Yeah, that's been sitting in the vaults for a couple months, and I didn't know what the hell to do with it.
Yeah, so we just kind of had that one, and then we kind of took it and made it our own. So, outside of that one, then there was Devil in Me. That one, what, how long did we work on that? Like
4 days.
4 days. And then Corporate La La Land. How long did we work on that one?
A day and a half.
A day and a fucking half. So this man's a master when it comes to music.
Okay, and don't you have a secret song that you're working on right now?
Okay, so...
Oh, yeah, I pimped.
Pimped, which...
hardcore punk song, Hell of Minor Threat.
Yeah, in the vein of Minor Threat. It's another punk song. We were working on it. It's not ready yet. That one's maybe had, like, 24 hours?
Yeah.
Less than 24 hours? So that one's not ready. We're not giving you guys the song that we just made 24 hours ago.
Okay.
And Drunken Stupor.
And aren't you writing a song about me, Jay?
Yes. Yes. Paul's Balls. The Balls of Paul. But that one's not ready yet either.
Okay. We're going to have to save that for Patreon.
Everyone keep...
Oh my god.
Okay. Yeah,
Luke's got something.
Yeah, that'll be closer. Yeah, that'll be
I still think it sounds better to the theme of Blue's Clues. It should be Paul's Balls, Paul's Balls, but you know, whatever you do you.
See, I want something more like Down with the Sickness.
Hey, we can go smoke a cigarette and then I'll just take the shit with me.
Yeah.
All right. So we're taking you on a little trip in my fucking rocket ship.
All right. On a trip in the rocket ship?
Yes. I'm about half. But you know what? No, I can't. No, I shouldn't. We're live. I can't fucking shotgun a beer, man.
Yeah, you can.
I mean, we could.
So like I'm just kind of like do whatever the fuck you want, screw your career, let this
yeah well, I mean, that's what everyone loves about you, Luke.
Aww.
I'll back it up and then you can scoot in
backing up back that ass up for me, daddy.
It's hey daddy. we're live.
We
are live. You cannot be saying those things.
Absolutely. In fact, this boosts viewership.
Fuck censorship.
Yeah, fuck censorship.
Oh, don't worry. I'm an 18 plus, so we're covered.
Gaston wants to say, suck your scatty, good lyrics. So,
hey.
Thank you, Gaston.
No one writes like Gaston. No one plays like Gaston. Nobody ever carries a tray like Gaston.
I love life. This is fun.
Oh my god. Yes, this is great. This is
now
great.
I can see your beautiful faces now. Hello, y'all.
Oh, we can see your beautiful face now, so there we go.
Even trade.
Meow.
Oh yeah. Here you go, man.
Thank you.
My lighter literally died, like, right before the live. I've been, like, going to my stove and turning on the burner because I can't, like,
my first one.
Buy another lighter. And I have
yeah.
to. I'm sad.
I saw the happy hand. I think that's adorable.
Oh, this?
Yeah, the happy hand. Like, I've got a lot of people in my life who do that. So, like, I totally get it. Like, I do it sometimes too. You know, hashtag neurodivergent.
Honestly, yeah. All of us in this band.
Yeah.
But that's what makes us so great.
I have very few neurotypical friends. I just keep attracting people who are as broken as me, and I love that for me. It's like none of the wiring was done by professionals for any of us. It was Joe down the street who did it for like a six-pack of Bud Light, and he fucked it all up.
You did what for a six-pack of Bud Light?
Budweiser.
I actually don't even like beer. I like hard liquor, and that's it.
Oh, what's your poison of choice? Oh,
everything. I'll do Red Bull and vodka or Jack and Coke, though, if I'm at the bar. And ooh, yeah. I will drink Southern Comfort straight from the fucking bottle. I don't need a chaser.
I used to drink Southern Comfort whenever I was just, like, sick. I don't know why. It just felt like a better cough syrup than anything.
For real! It's just like cough syrup. Like, I can't be trusted with NyQuil. I'm just saying.
I haven't had a drink since April 3rd of 1993, but I tell you, Jay has put me in a position to where cranberry vodka is sounding pretty goddamn good right now.
Oh, yo, vodka cranberries. They were serving them
at the wedding.
At the wedding we attended last weekend.
They were there. The wedding that I crashed. They
were at the wedding.
Yeah.
Yeah. We were groomed for our bassist Alex's wedding, our bassist in our other band. Yeah, he got married to his wife last week.
Oh. Jay, wasn't that when you did the lemonade fireballs? It was a horrible, horrible idea.
Yes, they had fireball shots, and they were serving fucking, it was whiskey sour.
Yeah, it was whiskey sour.
Whiskey sours, and I was like, hey, instead of the regular whiskey, fucking put fireball instead. Best, worst mistake I've ever made.
Yeah, I remember, now, I didn't want to take a sip of that.
Now,
I didn't want to take a sip of that because it was bad.
You guys know what a depth charge is, right?
A what?
A depth charge. It's when they take a shot and they drop it in a beer and then you chug it. So it's like usually a shot.
Oh, yeah, I've heard that by another name. That's called a Boilermaker.
Okay.
I've seen that.
Now, when I was in my prime drinking days, we used to take cinnamon schnapps and do the same thing and drop it in Everclear and go.
Oh, dear Lord, Everclear.
Cornelia, yes, Irish car bombs. That's what I was going to say. That's what we call them, too. They're fucking gross.
That as Irish trash can. Or is that a different cocktail?
I'm not sure. But one thing that still throws me off is the fact that in the UK, lemonade is just Sprite.
They just call it Sprite?
No, they just call it lemonade. Lemonade is just Sprite.
Wait, so they call Sprite lemonade?
No. Yes. There is no lemonade. American lemonade doesn't fucking exist over there. They think that's like the worst shit ever.
You can tell because I'm confused.
You can call it lemon punch. You can call it lemon punch.
You could, but I don't think that's what they like.
Like what? I mean, if you got a nice glass of lemonade, you can just put a shot of whiskey in it, but then you got a whiskey sour, and now we've come full circle. Speaking of which, shout out to Full Circle Brewing Company. Those guys are awesome. Yeah. I love their beer. They've hosted all sorts of awesome live events here.
They've had us on their stages multiple times.
Me and him.
Wow. Yeah.
We have yet to debut with this one over here. But, Jay, I think it'll be a fantastic debut indeed.
Well, if we're going to do it, we should at least set up a phone so that we can do like a live stream to either Twitter or Instagram.
Oh, yeah, definitely. I can talk to the promoter head honcho and get us in.
We can perform. Have you ever done a snowblower margarita?
What is that?
That sounds delicious.
Snowblower margarita. The rim is not lined with salt. It's lined with Coke. And
I suspected.
And you snort the line and guzzle the margarita.
Okay, that's kind of like a champagne supernova in the sky.
Great reference.
Shout out to Oasis.
Yes, that was one of my favorite drinks.
Damn.
I could do a couple dozen of those a night. Yeah, that's why I don't drink anymore.
It's like, where am I going? Like, which way did he go, George? Like,
yeah.
Where did he go, George? Which way did he go?
Which way did he go? Which way did he go?
Very. That way.
I'm very tame in the alcohol world.
Speak up. Share. Yes.
I'm very tame in the alcohol world. I just like beer and vodka.
Paul's ball is so deserving, says Cornelia.
Hi, Cornelia.
You got to remember, I spent 20 years in the casino industry, and it was drugs, sex, and rock and roll, and alcohol. That's all it was.
Oh, speaking of Paul and what Paul does, if you want us to do like a little campaign song for you, let us know. It'll be gnarly.
Isn't that Paul's Balls?
We're doing Paul's Balls as a campaign song? Do you want that as your campaign song?
Oh, yeah.
Balls to stand up. To
right. Big you got to make it so it sounds something like Down with the Sickness, you know, Disturbed, Down with the Sickness.
Oh, I love that fucking song. I love Disturbed so much. Probably my favorite, though, is Stupefy. I don't know. I'm a basic bitch like that. Oh, my God. Like, their cover of The Sound of Silence, like, ooh, they took that and just, oh, made it new, you know?
Yes, yes. I could never try cocaine. I would love it, and I can't afford to love it. Absolutely true. Absolutely true.
Oh, very true.
Hey, that reminds me of this one-liner that George Carlin said. The good thing about cocaine is that it makes you feel like a new man. The bad thing about cocaine is that new man wants more coke.
Yeah.
R.I.P. George Carlin. Truly one of the greats.
Oh, definitely. Hey, I love you, sir. I love you, man. Yes, George Carlin is one of my favorites. He brings the truth and makes you laugh. Think about it. George Carlin never told a joke. He just came out and told you a story, and you laughed your ass off.
Very true. I think that's like the essence and realness of stand-up comedy, because it's like they get up on stage and like it's public speaking. That's really all it is. Yes. It's just public speaking in a way, in the context of people laughing, you know? So it's like you form a real intimate connection with a comedian, but it's just like, I'm up here making all you guys laugh, making sure you have a good time, and I'm just telling stories. Like,
yeah. See, now I can go back to the oldies and all that. You're probably too young to remember Richard Pryor, one of the greatest.
Oh, I know who Richard Pryor is.
Okay, Richard Pryor. And did you know he sang? He was a musician.
Oh, that's so cool. I did not know that, actually.
Yeah, look up some of the songs that Richard Pryor sung. The man could sing. He had a voice like you wouldn't believe.
Oh, but, wow. Yeah. I can't believe it.
Yeah, Richard Pryor. Eddie Murphy, of course, you guys know. He's one of my favorites. Chris Rock. Chris Rock's another one that brings the truth. Chappelle. Carlin, you know.
Patrice O'Neill.
Yep, yep. But, yes, I love comedy. Love comedy.
Me too.
And I hate comedy shows. I can't stand a comedy show, but I love a good comedian, you know? So.
Mm-hmm. Are we all done with stogies?
Yeah, I'm good, man.
I think we're all done with stogies, yeah.
To back in? All right.
Uh-huh. All right. Corporate La La Land?
Yeah. Yep.
All right.
We've been talking a big game about this one, so now it's about time we whip it out. Hopefully I can get the...
Yes, yeah. Yes.
Lucas, it's perfect. It doesn't need to be good. But you know me, I'm...
A perfectionist, we know.
Me too. But recently I've let go of that a little bit.
All right. And everybody watching, got questions. Start loading the questions up, because they're going to play that... song, and so get those questions coming up.
All right, how's the
nope?
Okay,
nope. Hey, it happens. Excuse me.
How does it look?
I think we're good.
Looks good. Looks good.
Yeah. Well,
time to run.
All right. My last code is 1776.
Right.
I need the Miss
America.
Oh, it's already unlocked.
Ah! Oh, no! The baby!
threw the baby out with the bath water.
Ouch. Ouch.
There was no bath water.
It was all just ow.
Much better. Thank you. Thank you.
Are you okay? Are you guys okay?
I'm doing better now. I'm standing up again.
Excellent. Excellent.
I don't trust it. I don't.
Maybe it's because it's on the charger cable.
Could be. The last thing I want is for this thing to fucking fall again.
Yeah.
All right. I think it'll be good unless we rock out so much the sound knocks it over. But
I'm willing to take that risk. Do not speak that into existence.
Test.
Knock on the door.
All right.
Big bones.
All right. So
big bones.
I need to use it. Hold it up like this.
Gotcha.
All right.
Third song, Vainglory, Corporate La La Land.
Okay.
Oh, also follow us on all the social medias at Vainglory Goth on Twitter, on Instagram, and Facebook.
Yeah.
I gotta
say, this is Corporate La La Land.
Corporate La La Land. Riddle me this. It's truer than true. We live in a country where you're red or you're blue. Two-party system just feels like a scam, where you only feel safe with a gun in your hand. Corporate land, where everything is fucked. Say no for dollar bills and we're all on drugs. Corporate land, where a full steer is right.
They rocked out too hard. Hey, with us.
Let's go.
Was it the cat?
Looks like Apple got
It didn't.
The phone was headbanging.
It was the wire, man. It's curving too much.
Hey, the phone was headbanging though.
It was.
Looks like Apple got pissed.
Yeah, they don't like it. They want us to keep buying in.
Fuck off, Apple.
This is what we're talking about in this song, man.
Yeah, see, this is the kind of shit we're getting angry about.
All right, so I'll do it unplugged.
Start from the top again.
All right.
Corporate La La Land, take two. Riddle me this. It's truer than true. We live in a country where you're red or you're blue. The two-party system just feels like a scam, where you only feel safe with a gun in your hand. Corporate La La Land, where everything is fucked. Take over dollar bills and we're all on drugs. Corporate La La Land. You live in a mansion up in Beverly Hills. So nice you forgot that fentanyl kills. Excuse the profanity, but your country is fucked. Drive us to insanity. So we buy a new truck. Corporate La La Land, where everything is fucked.
Bravo!
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Gracias.
Gracias, gracias, danke schön.
Oi.
Cornelia gave you a couple of hearted eyes here. She's loving it, loving it.
We're Vainglory. Follow our socials. Fucking plugs up the fucking plugs.
All right. T-Paw said, already hit the like button. Thank you, T-Paw. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. We love you.
Yes. Got to move it up in the algorithm. We got to get this out there.
Hey. Coming up in the world.
Don't trust nobody. Gotta look over your shoulder constantly.
I remember the days when I was a young kid growing up, looking in the mirror, dreaming about blowing up the rock lines, make money, chill with the bunnies, sign autographs, or whatever the people want from me. Shit, right? It's funny how impossible dreams manifest in the games that we come up with it. But nevertheless, you got to get from the gusto, but you don't know all the blood, sweat, and tears, and listen to what can fears.
Oh, I love that song. It's a good song. It's a good song.
So you want to be a rap superstar and live large?
Do you have my card?
You ready guys rocked it.
Thank you. Howdy.
We try.
I can fit into the frame because I'm short. I'm a towering 5'5", y'all.
I'll stand back here so I can fit in.
I should probably.
Howdy.
Jay looks 6 foot now.
Who said I wasn't? Who lied?
Yeah. How tall are you, Jay?
Okay, technically not 6 foot, but what is 2 inches?
Okay. A lot of difference.
Is it?
Yeah, 2 inches makes a lot of difference.
I've never had any complaint about my inches.
Have you ever parked a car before? No. That's what we're talking about.
I was talking about my penis.
Well, thank you for putting it up.
You're welcome.
Lucas, how tall are you? How tall are you?
I am 5'10".
Yeah, we're about the same. Right. He's just further in the frame.
Resident short guy.
All right. Well, I can't wait until I join you guys because I am 6'4".
Woo! Let's go.
Whoa.
We can form a gradient. Like, I'm first, then him, then Jay, then you. Band photo.
Yeah, band photo. Like, we'll just stand there just like, with like the cholo lean.
It's been a great show.
It's been a
thank
great
you,
show.
Cornelia.
Yes, thank you, Cornelia.
Thank you.
You should join and play the electric triangle for us.
All right. So, your other bands. Now, if memory serves me correctly, are both of you got your own side projects going where you're both in other bands?
So, for me, no other band. I have no other. For me, there's only Vainglory. Until the day I die. But Caesar and Lucas, they are in Forgotten Faces as well as Vainglory. But they can go into details on that. I'll pass.
Well, we lost you. There you go. You're back. We lost you for a second. Can you hear me? Can't hear you. Can't hear you. Can't hear you.
Hi, Paul. Now that
Hi.
We're
now I can hear you.
Let's talk shit about the band.
See, why would you say that? Why would you say that, Luke?
Huh? What?
Why would you do this to us?
I say nothing. I don't know what
Damn, I'm caught in 4K.
But yes, Caesar, other projects, other bands.
Okay. All right. Okay, well, myself and Lucas over here, we are in a 4-man death metal band called Forgotten Faces. Lucas plays drums. Yep. I play guitar, but I also do vocals full-time for it.
our sound can be likened to something similar to As I Lay Dying, The Faceless, In Flames, Killswitch Engage.
Dream Theater.
Yeah, a little bit of Dream Theater in there.
Between the Buried and Me.
Oh, yeah. Big influence of ours. BT Bam. Saw them live once. It was a surreal experience.
Lamb of God.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, we love Lamb of God.
A little bit of Deftones as well. At least on my end.
Yeah, this guy will talk your ear off about Deftones. We love Deftones because they make us horny but sad at the same time.
What more could you want?
Now, I know I threw out their Lamb of God. I'm not actually a big death metal fan. In school, I had a teacher that actually had us write papers on different bands. And I had to write a paper on Lamb of God, and I had no idea who in the hell they were. But I loved their lyrics, even though I couldn't understand them when they sung. You had the lyrics, and I read the lyrics, and it was just like, oh, shit, I like this. I wish I could understand them.
No kidding. Fucking Randy Bly, the expert lyricist, that guy, fantastic writer. And funny enough, out of a lot of the bands that I've listened to in that vein of music, he's, like, one of the easier vocalists to understand, which is so weird. Like, his enunciation and diction are so clear. Like, compared to a lot of other things I've listened to, like, yeah, that's talking status.
Yeah.
Let's see here. T-Paw's Playground. I enjoyed what you guys played. I've heard bands who try locally and just are okay. Thank you. That means a lot. Thank you. Thank you.
And the fact that you guys have only been playing together for a week, I mean, you guys rocked it. I mean, literally, you guys rocked it. You're awesome. Thank you.
Well, let's be honest. Like, us rehearsing, it's been, like, maybe 5 days of rehearsing after, like, the construction and all that.
5 days straight.
5 days straight of being piss-fucking-drunk, crafting, creating, and then, like, finalizing it just for your show.
Well, and playing it in your living room without proper, you know, sound and all of that stuff and all that. You guys, again, it was great. I mean, shit.
Thank you.
What more can you ask for?
It felt natural because we practiced it in my living room as well.
That's actually where all the rehearsals took place in their living rooms.
We wrote all the songs in my living room.
Dude, we wrote
Devil
most
and
of
me
it.
It used to be a Cure ripoff, but then we were like, hey, this kind of, let's double time it. And then we realized it sounded like REM's It's the End of the World as We Know It.
Oh, there's actually, it hasn't been recorded yet, but like towards the end, like right after we say the last, but you love me because it's the end of the world as we know it. And then
I feel like shit.
And then we just rip it from there. But yeah, good fun.
All right. All right, really, and
it's not even my genre of music, and it was incredible. Thank you. Thank you. That means a lot. Thank you. Really appreciate it.
Well, we are at that point in time where we're going to have to call the show. It's been a great show. And what I'm going to do, since I have the three of you here, we're going to do an after show, and people are going to have to jump into my Patreon to check out the after show. So we're going to talk about the nitty-gritty. I think I'm going to talk to these guys about their sex lives. So if you women are interested, if you men are interested, you're going to want to check that out. So everyone, remember, be kind, be happy, and may good things come your way. Have a good day.
Peace, geez.
Peace.